Hi everyone, Jordan from ENTTEC here. Today, we're going to discuss the different available pixel tape options and how those options might relate to the needs of your installation. This video will go into some of the details and differences of various types of tape and what applications they're typically used for to help give you an idea of what might be the best strip for your installation. Before we go too much further, it's worth noting that we're not going to cover everything in this video. If you are putting together an installation, it's up to you to make sure that you've spec'd everything properly and you've taken into consideration all the relevant safety needs for your installation. If you'd like to purchase ENTTEC tape or controllers, or would like a little bit of a hand deciding what you might need, we'd be happy to help. Just get in contact with your relevant office. Before we dive right in, if you want to hear more tips and tricks, or you want to stay up to date with the latest ENTTEC news and products, or if you want to be notified when we go live, then hit that subscribe button and the bell so you don't miss a thing. Make sure you stay to the end because we'll be giving you our one most important tip to consider when purchasing LED tape that could save you hundreds of dollars on your next installation. Now, there are two main categories of tape to consider: pixel tape, also known as individually addressable tape, and constant voltage. Both of these tapes are described as LED tape, so it can get a little confusing when you're trying to differentiate what does what. Constant voltage is the simplest tape between the two of them. This is because all LEDs on the strip will change color, brightness, or intensity in sync with each other. Whereas pixel tape gives you the ability to individually change the color or brightness of each pixel or group of pixels individually. Today we'll be looking into pixel tape and the variations within these tapes. There are five main things to consider when purchasing LED tape for your installation. They are protocol, voltage, whether you want RGB or RGBW, the pixels per meter of the tape, and something that a lot of people don't think about, but that's the actual backing color of the tape. Let's start with voltage. At ENTTEC we supply either 5 or 12 volt tape options, but 24 volt tape is available on the market. We will explain shortly why we don't stock it here. 5 volt tape tends to have a 1 LED to 1 pixel resolution and is significantly brighter than our 12 volt tape options. However, it has a relatively short maximum run length before voltage drop becomes an issue, and this is around 5 meters. This means it does require power to be injected more frequently than 12 volt tape, which means that you need to spend more space and more money to power your installation properly. This is perfect for small installations where you want to illuminate something simple like an artistic piece with a floating light. On the other hand, 12 volt tape is great if you have limited space or resources to power your installation. 12 volt tape typically only needs to be power injected every 8 meters, with some of our tape variations extending up to 11.5 meters without needing a second power injection. This allows for longer and more complicated runs with lower power requirements, that is to say, less power supplies. This saves you time and money. This tape typically achieves this by grouping 3 LEDs into 1 pixel. This basically lowers the resolution by a third and essentially amounts to a HD versus standard definition change in video. However, we have created a 12 volt tape that has a 1 pixel to 1 LED resolution, so you get a similar visual output to our 5 volt tape, but you get the advantage of long tape runs with minimal power injections that 12 volt tape provides. This tape is perfect for most installations because of the aforementioned long possible tape runs off one power supply, and you get that 5 volt resolution. There are 24 volt versions of tapes which are based off this trend, which are able to go to about 15 meters without needing another power injection. Unfortunately, it is a bit too good to be true. Lots of 24 volt strings usually need another power injection at about 10 meters, which is the same as our 12 volt tape anyway. Another downfall of 24 volt tape is that it's grouped into lots of 6 LEDs for 1 pixel. This means the resolution is essentially dropped by a sixth, which causes the appearance to be quite blocky. The one upside to 24 volt tape is you can have the installation further away from the power supply than 12 or 5, which will work in very niche cases, but it might be useful depending on your installation. Protocol is the next thing to discuss. If you're retrofitting into an existing Pixel installation, protocol might be something that you have to consider more carefully than if you're starting from fresh. If you're refreshing the old tape in existing Pixel bars, or if you have a set of controllers left over from a previous installation, you may need to pay more attention to the output protocol possible for your controller. This may mean you're stuck with a smaller selection of tape options if you need to use a specific controller. We actually recently updated our Octo firmware to allow for custom protocol timings. Stay tuned, we'll have a video detailing this process soon. Now let's talk about the difference between RGB and RGBW options. The most common available is RGB. This means that each LED is able to individually produce various brightnesses and intensities of red, green, and blue. When they're all on together, they'll produce a white light. However, this requires the LED to be running at its maximum capacity to produce white. This means you'll be using a lot of power. If your system is going to be playing lots of white color effects, or if you want finer control over white or the colors you're displaying, an RGBW strip then becomes your best option. Each pixel here can still produce the standard R, G, and B hues, red, green, and blue, but there is also an additional dedicated white LED. This allows you to have greater control over the color temperature and brightness of white that you're displaying. It also allows you to create more accurate pastels, and it simply widens the color range that you can produce with your lights. Using an RGBW versus an RGB LED means that you will have to use 4 channels per pixel instead of 3. Another thing to consider when choosing pixel tape is the number of pixels per meter. If you're purchasing tape from ENTTEC, you have the options of 30 or 60 pixels per meter. The main obvious difference is that 30 pixels per meter has half the number of pixels per meter than 60. Well, what does this actually mean? If you have a limited number of universes due to constraints in your controller setup, then 30 pixels per meter will allow you to cover a larger distance of tape with the same amount of universes of control. It also means that you simply won't have as many power injections in your installation. Because of this, you can make a compromise to save a little bit of money at the expense of the quality of the appearance of your display, obviously because there's half the resolution. 60 pixels per meter tends to be the standard in most installations because it provides a good balance of appearance, and most modern controllers allow you to control many universes. Our Octo, for instance, is able to control 8. So the universe control limitation is less relevant today. Something you may not have considered is the color of the backing of the tape itself. This might not come into mind immediately when thinking about LED tape, but it can be a small difference that makes a dramatic improvement to the overall look of your project. When purchasing from ENTTEC, you can get tape with either a black or white backing. The white backing is a standard and allows you to reflect more light to the outside world, which means the tape sometimes appears slightly brighter. However, if you're using your tape in a black room, when your LEDs are off, they might stand out a little bit more with the white backing. Black strips are designed to prevent external light reflection, which means you're able to conceal the workings of your installation more easily when the display is switched off. They also dissipate heat from the LEDs more effectively, simply due to emissivity. With this in mind, you can consider where your lights are going, and it's a good idea to think if black or white will work best. Now, as promised, our one tip that could save you hundreds on your next installation. It's a very simple tip. Do not cheap out when it comes to pixel tape. Now, it kind of might sound a little bit contradictory to spend more money to save, but trust me, we've heard of stories of projects that have become expensive very quickly because of cheap LED strip. This is because cheap LED strip is more likely to fail either during the process of the installation or shortly after runtime. This will result in more time spent replacing the tape, and if you're paying for labor, it will quickly cost way more than just spending the extra money on quality tape to start with. If you're going to install the tape yourself, then it will also save you time and stress because you're not having to fix the issues that usually involve replacing the tape altogether. If you are purchasing a lesser quality tape, you will need to purchase more tape in your initial run because you'll need to have more spares to replace any faults that come up. If you want a more in-depth look at the difference in the quality of LED strips, we will have a link in the video description shortly. That's it for today's video. Like, share, and subscribe if you found this video useful, and if you want to stay up to date with more videos like this or future unboxing live streams for new and upcoming products. You can comment down below if you have any questions or you think there's something that we missed. Don't forget, you can also check out our social media pages and stay tuned for more pixel strips and for more helpful ENTTEC tips. But 24 volt tape is also on there. God damn. No, it's my brain is just fading, I'm sorry. The other downfall of 12 volt tape is that it's grouped into lots of six LEDs
sorry,
into
24
one.
24 volt tape.
Yeah.
You said 12.
Oh.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go to the start. The light is simply, I lost so much. I lost so much. My brain can't look. It's like, therefore you'll need to purchase. I hated that presentation. So, oh yeah, right, okay. That's just me. Thanks for watching. If you like this video or you found it useful, please give us a thumbs up and maybe comment down below. You comment down below if you have something that we missed or you have any questions. Future unboxing live streams for new and upcoming products. Then, I burped, sorry.